The place for comic book and anime reviews.
Hey you guys, this is Brandon Couch on YouTube for all your comic book and anime reviews. And today I'm doing my review of Champions, issue number 10. So, as of late, we kind of had this kind of rocketing going with the Champions as of late, the Champions book overall. But they've had a few little rocky issues opening up until this point. A few of them haven't been as good as we wanted them to be. There have been a few that haven't been, like, amazing ones. But with this issue and the last issue, I think we're kind of seeing some nice little build up here. So in this issue of Champions, we get to see basically this is the Secret Empire tie-in for Champions, and we know that Hydra has been taking over all of these places, and they've been made all the Inhuman camps. And one of the big things here is that since Kamala was one of the members of the Champions, the team is pretty much worried because then they haven't seen her. Because we all know that she's been with the Secret Warriors all this time, kind of like going around destroying Inhuman camps. But they don't know that's what's going on with Kamala. They don't know where Kamala is right now. And they're just going around looking for her, looking for their friend Kamala. And they're just worried that she has been locked in one of these Inhuman camps. And basically, they end up finding one of these camps. And they end up liberating all the Inhumans on that camp and freeing them. Well, while they're doing, because they're looking for Kamala while they're doing this, but what they don't realize is when they do this is that a lot of humans are kind of like scared at this point because they don't want to be running away from the law. They think that if now they've broken free from the Inhuman camp, that if the Hydra capture them this time, they'll undoubtedly kill them. And they don't really want that to happen to them. They don't want to die. Because they escaped and they're now like scared pretty much. And so like the Champions end up running this moral dilemma of if they should just give them back to Hydra or not, or if they should let them be free and then get captured on their own. Miles of course doesn't really want to take this whole idea, and so what he ends up doing is basically using kind of the idea to use Vision to kind of basically hide out the entire area so that way no Hydra soldiers could see what was going on there. While it's also going on, we also get this whole thing where they do find this girl who's been hiding out in this small little area who's also just so happened to be named Kamala as well, ironically, and she also is a big fan of Ms. Marvel. It's this weird type of thing that Mark Waid did. I don't get it really that much. I don't understand why we need to do like that. Kind of unbelievable that a girl called Kamala wants to be a Miss Marvel fan. That's a little weird. But they found out that she's been hiding out inside this little room and like she's been scared because of all the things that are going on with the Hydra camps right now. And she's been basically hiding out in this little building, and the rest of the Champions end up finding her and basically like trying to give her some hope a little bit and trying to kind of help to get kind of inspire her like a heroes would do. And they end up taking her with them away to kind of like find her some safety. Although it doesn't end with them like keeping her around. And she does end up going back, kind of get away from the town. Then she ends up does taking her back to, like, her caretaker, pretty much. And, you know, allowing her to kind of just live her life, hopefully away from all these Hydra goons, where she'll stay in this safe haven without any worry. And that's pretty much kind of where the issue ends off. So I really enjoyed this one, you guys, for the most part. I really did like it. I thought it was a really nice issue of Champions. There's a lot of little funny moments here, a little comedic banter that we kind of get from the Champions that I kind of really enjoyed. And so for the most part, I really liked this one. I honestly thought it was going to really just deal with like what Samurai Uprising was dealing with, where they were going to be like helping with Black Widow, but then to see they didn't go that route with him. They're kind of taking this other route for the main Champions book. But I still really enjoyed it for the most part. I'm showing you guys, there's my thoughts on Champion issue number 10. It all comes below what you guys thought about this issue of Champion. Did you guys enjoy it as much as I enjoyed it? And I'll catch you guys later. Peace out.